that as I thank you that you are the Lord of this nation, Father God. I thank you and I praise you. I lift up this nation to you, Father. And I thank you and I praise you, Father, that your hand is on us for good and not evil, Father God. I thank you, Father, that it is in your power, Father, to take up one and sit down another, pull down another, Father God. I thank you and I praise you for righteous men, Father. Godly men, Father, in our leadership positions, Father God. I want to thank you and I want to praise you, Father God. Oh, Lord God, I thank you and I praise you, Father, that you are putting those the righteous men that you're lifting them up, Father, but the unrighteous you're pulling down. Father God, I come against every demonic power, Father, the spirit that's trying to move in this nation, Father, tear this nation apart, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father God. I thank you that Satan, you have no place in this nation. Oh God, I thank you and I praise you, Father God. I thank you, Father, calling you to call on your people, Father, to fall on our faces, Father, before you, to intercede on behalf of this nation, Father, to pray for one another, Father, because not only is he trying to tear the nation down, he's trying to tear your church down, Father God. I thank you and I praise you that I give you glory, Father, give you honor and give you praise and thanksgiving, Father God. I thank you for who you are, Father God. Oh, you said we have not because we ask not, Father. We're asking you this day, Father. We're standing boldly before you, Father, as your children, Father. We thank and we praise you, Father, that you watch over your word to perform it, Father God. You said it would not return into your void, Father God. I thank you and I praise you as we call on you today, Father, that you're in this place, Father God. You're in this place, Father. You're moving by your spirit, Father. It's not about us, Father. It's all about you, Father God. Show us, Father. Direct us, guide us, lead us, teach us, Father God. Be with us, Father God. Oh, I thank you and I praise you, Lord God, as I give you the glory, give you the honor, give you the praise and thanksgiving, Father God. Oh, God, I thank you. And I praise you, Father, for who you are, Father. You are the Lord. You change not, Father. You're the same yesterday, today, and forever, Father God. Oh, Father, what you've done for the least of us, you'll do for the highest of us, Father. I thank you and I praise you, Lord God. I give you glory. Oh, Father. Oh, you said there's no good thing that you will withhold from us, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father. We call on the good today, Father God. We're thanking you for the good, Father God. We're thanking you, Father God. Oh, Father, I thank you for our spirit of excellence, Father, that's flowing through this ministry, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father, that your hand is on us for good, Father God. Oh, God, I thank you and I praise you, Father God. I bless your name. I bless your name, Father. We pray traveling mercies, Father, for those that are on their way, Father God. Those that had a heart to come, Father, I thank you that they'll show up today, Father God. I thank you that we're calling from the north and from the south, from the east and from the west, Father God. By your spirit, by our spirit, you're moving by your spirit, Father God. Oh, we don't always understand, Father, but we know that you have a plan. We thank you and I praise you, Father God. That's all, Father, I thank you. And I praise you, Father God. Oh, God, bless your name. Bless your name. Bless your name. Oh, Father, I thank you that I continue to set myself in agreement with those that have prayed for the service today, Father God. I thank you that you'll come by your spirit, Father. Your spirit will move this day, Father God. I thank you for the word that's coming forth, Father. Be life-changing, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Lord God, as I give you the glory. Give you the honor, give you the praise, Father, to pray for the man and woman of God, Father God. I thank you for the roles that you've set in this body, Father, gifts that you've given us, Father God. Oh, Father, I thank you for them, that your hand is upon them for good, Father, that you surround them, Father, with your love. I thank you that they hear, they're careful to hear your voice, Father God, and they do only those things that you called them to do, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father, that you supply their every need. There's no lack in their lives, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father. I pray for their children, Father God, that your angels encamped around and about them, Father, delivering them from every evil work, Father. I declare there's no weapon formed against them that shall prosper, Father, for you made them the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, blessed coming in and blessed going out, Father. Blessed in the cities, blessed in the fields, Father God. I thank you and I praise you, Father. I pray for the body here, Father God. I lift them up, Father God. I thank you and I praise you for that your hand is among them for good and not evil, Father. I thank you for those that have been faithful, Father God, that they will be rewarded, Father, that their labor will not be in vain, Father God. I thank you that you continue to encourage them, Father. Continue to lift them up, Father. I continue to thank you and praise you, Father God, and give you the glory, Father. I thank you for what you're doing, Father, in this ministry, Father God. We may not see it now, Father. We may not see it now, Father, but the best is yet to come. Oh, God, I thank you and I praise you, Lord God, as I give you the glory, Father God, give you the honor, give you the praise, Father. We'll look back on these lean days, Father, be able to give you praise, Father, to glorify you, magnify you, Father God, and thank you from where you brought us, Father, for your word declares that you brought us from a long way, Father. You've got us from a mighty, oh, the old saints used to say you brought us from a mighty long way. Oh, God, I thank you. Praise you, Lord God. I thank you and I praise you and I magnify you, Father. There is none like you, Lord. There is none like you, Father. Nobody can do what you do, Father God. And I thank you and I praise you, Father. And I give you the glory. I give you the honor, Father God. Father God, I thank you. Thank you, Father God. Bless your name. Bless your name. Oh, Father, I thank you. Oh, Father God. God. Oh, God, you're good. You're good. You're a good God, Father. I thank you, Father, for who you are. Oh, Father, I thank you that, you're Jehovah Jireh, Father. You supply our needs, Father, whether it's physical, whether it's financial, whether it's social, Father God. You're supplying all our needs, Father God. And there's no lack in any of our lives, Father God. Oh, Father God, I thank you and I praise you as we stretch our hands to you, Father. No other help we know. And if you withdraw from us, Father, where are we going to go? Father God, I thank you and I praise you, Father, that you never left us. You've never forsaken, Father. You said you'd be with us even until the end of the age, Father God. We thank you and we praise you for it, Father God. We praise you for being Jehovah, Father. We give you praise and thanksgiving, Father. Bless your name. Bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Father, we ask these prayers and in Jesus' name, Father God. We thank you and praise you for it. Amen and amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Bless you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we bless you this morning. We give you praise, glory, and honor for what you're going to do, Lord. We thank you. We thank you, Father, for quality decisions being made today, Lord. We thank you, Father, for lives being changed, Lord. We thank you, Lord God. We give you all the praise, glory, and honor for what you are going to do, Lord. You are God Almighty. Father, you are Lord, Master, and King. We bless you this morning, Father, for your word says that you are Jehovah. So we thank you this morning for being Jehovah. You are the great and mighty God. Hallelujah, Father. We bless you. Good morning. Good morning, family and friends of the Bridge Church of Alabama. How many of you know we serve a great and mighty God? Hallelujah. Glory to God. You are God. And you're in control, seated high. You are Lord of all. Great I am, sovereign ruler, Lion of Judah. You are God.
You are God. And you're in control,
seated high.
Seated high. You are Lord of all.
Great I am.
Great I am, sovereign.
Lion of Judah,
you are God.
Things will change
when we call
on that name, Great Jehovah.
Things will change
when we call
on that name,
Great Jehovah.
Things will change
On that name, Great Jehovah. Things will change
when we call
on that name. Everybody clap your hands. If you know our God is good, and if you know he's worthy
God. You are God, and you're in control,
seated high.
You are Lord of all.
Great I am,
sovereign,
Lion of Judah.
You are God.
Things will change
when we call
on that name, Great Jehovah.
Things will change
when we call
on that name,
Great Jehovah. Things will change
when we call
on that name,
Great
Jehovah.
Things
Lord. We declare you to be Lord God Almighty this morning. Hallelujah. We will bless you, oh God. Hallelujah. For you have created everything, oh God. Oh, Father God, you created it all, oh God. You are mighty God. You are mighty God. Hallelujah. If you know the Lord is mighty, give him a shout this morning.
Lord, you're
mighty. Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord, our answer is your name.
You said your glory.
You said your glory above the heavens and the earth.
When I think of all,
when I think of all, you made the sun, the moon, the stars.
No praise,
no praise is high enough to express. How great you are.
What a mighty God we serve.
What a mighty God we serve.
We serve a mighty God.
Mighty God we serve.
Angels bow before you.
Angels,
oh Lord.
Bow before
the mighty God.
The mighty God we serve.
What a Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Lord, you're mighty.
Declare it with us this morning.
Lord, you're mighty.
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 Oh, Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. All glory, all honor, all praise, all praise.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All glory.
All glory.
All honor.
All honor.
All praise.
All praise.
All praise.
All praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All glory.
All glory.
All honor.
All honor.
All praise.
All praise.
Hallelujah.
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 We give you all the glory.
All glory.
All honor.
All praise.
All praise.
All praise.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah, King of glory. Oh, we bless you today, oh God. Oh, hallelujah, Father. We all worship you, Lord. The world adores you, oh God. Hallelujah. We bless your name this morning.
Yes, the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man.
Place. I just wanna be with you. I just wanna be with you.
Yes, the world bow down and say you are God.
Every man
will bow down and say you are King.
So let's start right now.
So let's start.
Why would we
wait? We can praise you now in victory, King of glory. Fill this place.
I just wanna be with you. Just wanna be. King of glory,
King of glory,
fill this place. I
just wanna be with you.
I just wanna be with you.
Just wanna be with you.
So we'll sing hallelujah
until you come again. And we'll dance in your presence until you come again. We will sing hallelujah until you come again. And we'll dance in your presence until you come again. We will sing
hallelujah
until you
come again.
And we'll dance in your presence
until you come again.
We will sing hallelujah.
Father, we bless you. We give you glory and honor this morning, oh God. For you are King of glory. You are King of power. You are King of Peace. Hallelujah. We bless you this morning. We exalt you this morning, oh God. We make you large, oh God. We make you large, oh God. Be magnified, oh God. Be magnified, Lord, in our lives. Be magnified in our hearts today, oh God. Oh, Father, we turn our lives over to you, oh God. We make you Jehovah, our master, oh God. Lord, over us, oh God. We bless you. We put our lives in your hand, Father. We thank you, Lord God, that as we come upon this Thanksgiving, oh God, we thank you, Father, for everything that you have already done. If you don't do another thing, oh God, we say thank you anyway, God. Thank you, Lord God, for how you kept us, oh God. Thank you, Lord God, how you got us in our right mind, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for how you've kept us, oh God. Thank you, God, for how you've made a way out of no way, God. Thank you, God. Thank you just for who you are. Just for being who you are, God. We thank you. Thank you for being so merciful. Thank you for being so full of grace. Thank you, God, for loving us when we didn't love ourselves. Oh, God, thank you. Thank you, God, thank you. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for Jesus. We thank you. Oh, and it is in his mighty, matchless name, oh God. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.
We'll dance in your presence until you come again. We will sing hallelujah until you come again. We will dance in your presence until you come again. Yes, God. Yes, God. We're stripping it all off, 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 God. We're giving it all to you. We're stripping it all off, God. Yes, God. Oh, glory, God. Bless your name, God. Yes. All the glory, all the praise, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, Lord God. Yes, Lord God. Oh, thank you, God. Yes, 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 yes. Good morning, good morning, good morning, Bridge Church of Alabama. Good morning. Woo, praise God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Woo, thank you, God. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Woo, good morning. Woo. My name is Kenya Pinnegar, and I'm here before you today to not only welcome my first-time guests, but give a few announcements. So first, above all, I want to welcome any first-time guests here in the building or tuning into our live stream. If you'll just wave at us here in the building, or if you're on our live stream, drop a wave, drop a heart. Just let us know you're out there. We want to show you some love and welcome you into the family. Amen. And as I always say, the first time you're a guest, the second time you're family. Amen? Amen. So family, let's show a little love and just welcome them. Whoop, 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 whoop. Amen, amen, amen. And on behalf of our pastor, Terrence Nolan, and our other pastor, LaShula Nolan, we just want to welcome you here to the Bridge Church of Alabama. Amen. We don't believe that God has sent you here by accident. We know that there is something here for you today, and we pray that you get what you came for. Amen. Amen. Whew, moving on to our announcements. Ooh, amen. Just, you know, it's just great to be thankful sometime, you know. Y'all, I'm just thankful. Just thankful. Whew. You know, I'm going to say this. There are times when we're not okay. Let's just, you know, we say transparency. Let's just be transparent. There are times we are not okay. We got to understand that it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to not be okay. But we have to understand that even when we're not okay, that God has still got us. That God still has us. Y'all, I went through a trying time in the last couple of weeks. Just emotionally tired, physically tired. Oh, my God, just tired in every sense of the word. Mentally, just a lot of things, you know. And I know I don't share a lot because a lot of times I'm so used to going through things by myself. But God is telling me to let somebody know out there, it's okay. It's okay. It's okay to not be okay, but don't let go of God. Don't let go of God. He is still your strength. He is still your power. He is still your the one who picks you up and carries you. He carries you through it, even through every single emotion. But sometimes we need to feel the emotion. You know, we negate sometimes. We ourselves, a lot of times we put it on other people, but it's not other people, it's us. We negate how we feel because we're supposed to be so super spiritual that we're not supposed to feel things. But we feel. We're still human. We're still living in this human body. So we still feel. We still feel the rejection. We still feel everything that we go through. We still feel it. But just don't forget about God. Just don't forget that He is there when it seems no one is there. He is there. I'm telling you, because today I'm only here because He is there. Because He is there. I woke up this morning, y'all, with a new attitude, if it will, the best way to describe it. I woke up refreshed. I woke up feeling like myself, you know, because sometimes you go through, you just don't feel like yourself. But I woke up this morning feeling like myself. Amen. So I don't know who God wanted me to say that for, but, you know, I pray that it touched somebody. Amen. I'm sure He didn't have me share that just for no reason. Because those who are family, y'all know I don't I don't share a lot. But, you know, when I do share, I feel as though when I do share, God has me sharing for a purpose. So, you know, I pray that reached somebody. Somebody needs to know that it's okay to not be okay. But don't forget about God. That's just don't forget about God. Amen. Amen. That's why I can say, King of Glory, fill this place. Fill this place. Because sometimes we say place and we're thinking the outward place. But God says, no, I need to fill this place. Because sometimes the outward place, the place I may have you in, may not look okay. But if I fill this place, it doesn't matter what's going on out here. Because my peace is in this place. My joy is in this place. My God is in this place. Amen. Amen. It's in this place. And as long as it's in this place, I don't have to worry about what's going on in this place. Ooh, Lord God, because as you look at the government, the news, everything, I mean, if we just forget about God and just focus on that, we would all be crazy. We would all be crazy. But that's why he has to fill this place. Ooh, amen. Ooh, glory, glory, amen. Oh, like I said, I don't know who that was for. I did not get up here to intend on doing that, but God, amen. Ooh, okay, I'm going to try to move on to these announcements. Amen. Amen. First and foremost, we want to thank everyone for their contributions to our annual Thanksgiving basket giveaway. We will be able to bless 25 families. Amen. Whoop, 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 whoop. Amen. They will have the fixings for Thanksgiving dinner for a family of four, and then they'll also receive a $25 gift card for the meat of their choice. So they'll be able to pick whatever they want to go with their meal. Amen? Amen. Amen. Also, for our guys, where our fellas at? Men in place. Whoop, 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 whoop. Now, I'm gonna make this announcement, but I'm going to do a sidebar after I make this announcement. But however, the Iron Bowl Fellowship for the Men will be held at Pastor Terrence and Pastor Trilla's house. Amen. Saturday, November the 27th. More information will be coming from Pastor, but howsoever. Women of Purpose, where y'all at? We like football too, don't we? Amen, amen. We like to cheer on our squads as well. So I think as a sidebar, Women of Purpose, I think this might be a purpose we need to jump on. We might need to crash this party. But no, me and y'all come out. Please come out and enjoy y'all fellowship. You know, we all like to have fun and games. But, you know, me and y'all need to have y'all time just like we do. Amen, amen. So, yeah, y'all please come out and enjoy that. Pastor will give y'all more information. Amen. All right, our Women of Purpose. Whoop, 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 whoop. We in the building as well. Also, just a slight reminder, if you have not checked your emails, please check your emails. You should have received emails concerning our events because we do have a couple of events coming up. So please check your emails and respond to those emails. There's an e-vite for our cookie swap, so please respond as soon as possible so that we can make sure we have an accurate number of the attendees, amen? And that cookie swap will be Friday, December 10th at 6:30 p.m., also at Pastor and Latrilla and Pastor Nolan's house, Terrence's house, amen? Amen. Also, our, hold on, I'm sorry, y'all. I think I might have skipped over something. I'm trying to make sure I didn't skip anything. Okay. Also, all those participating in our Secret Sisters gift exchange, please remain after service for just a few moments so that we can draw our names and get a little bit more information. Amen. And those who are participating, y'all, if you haven't, I mean, I'm telling you, it's going to be fun. I'm sure it's going to be real, real fun trying to discover who is your secret sister. Amen. But I've participated in things like this before, and it has been awesome. Amen. And it's just an opportunity in this time of Thanksgiving and this time of Christmas to just give to someone else and bless somebody else and make somebody else feel good. Amen. Amen. So let's just, like I said, participate in that and let's enjoy it. Amen. And just a few reminders, as usual, we do have our Wednesday night Bible study at 6:30 p.m. Here at the church and also here tuning in on our Facebook Live. So feel free to join us for that, as well as our in-person corporate prayer every first and third Saturdays at 11 a.m. here in the building, as well as the Wednesday morning prayer at 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. And again, all times that I have given are Central Standard Time, so make sure you adjust accordingly if you're on a different time zone, as well as if there's any events that we have mentioned and you would like to get more information on, go to our website at bridgechurchofal.com, click on our events link, and click on the event that you would like to attend for more information. Amen. All right, and now we will have our offertory message. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. I'm here, Minister Johnsy. I'm here to offer an offertory message. I don't think I'm going to be up here long, but let's go to John 3:16. And this is a very familiar passage of scripture. You know, pretty much if you're saved or you go to church, you pretty much know the scripture. And man, I would say it's almost one of the most known scriptures in the Bible. It says, for he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes on him should not perish but have everlasting life. What I want to bring out in this scripture is that God gave. He gave his best. God's very nature is a giving nature. That's who he is. He gives, you know. And this one he gave us, we would maybe perhaps die for something. You know, if it had to become a choice between Kenya and I having to die, well, I would choose me to die. You don't give up your children. You know what, not a mama. A mama bear will fight for her children. So we don't give up our children. So, you know, for women, we can kind of understand what God is saying here, that he gave his only begotten son. God gave us his best he had. And we need to learn that nature is in us. For we have God's spirit in us, his nature in us. And when you really get into this thing and get in the word and get more of the words you get into you, because that's more of the God you're getting into you, then you become more like him. You want to give. You come into place. I mean, sometimes I've had people just hand me a piece of candy, and especially when you're old, you know, the old traditional churches where you go to. And I mean, they don't you know, they're our foundation, but they would hand you a little piece of candy, a little peppermint, a little something. Yeah, just sometimes they just have that nature to give, and that's all they had to give. They didn't have a lot, but they give you what they had. And so that's what I want you to do, is that to understand that it's God's nature to give. And when, let me say before I go further, let's go to Exodus and look at chapter 35. Look at verses 4 and 5 is what I want to look at. Because it has to do with, now this is what this is going to be dealing with, is when the children had come out of Egyptian captivity, and they were getting ready to build a tabernacle in the wilderness. And God spoke to all the congregation of the children of Israel, saying, this is a thing which the Lord commanded, saying, take from among you an offering unto the Lord. Whosoever is of a willing heart, and let them bring it and make the offering of the Lord gold, silver, brass, and etc. He, I mean, the whole chapter that goes pretty much in what those people brought and gave to build this tabernacle. And this was a tent. But they brought everything that they need. I mean, that they needed. They brought it. But the thing I want you to key in on that, the willing heart. They were willing to give this. So that's what you got to be. When you're giving off, don't be putting it in there grudgingly of necessity. Put it in there with a willing heart, knowing the God that you serve, that you have his nature. And as he gives, then you want to give. And as he blesses you, you want to bless somebody else. And then, you know, you bring your tithes into the storehouse. He said, improve me.
God says, you know, I'm a big enough God that you can test me. I don't care about you testing me, because prove me and see if I want to open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. There's not room enough to receive it. You have more than enough. But you know, the thing about it, you won't ever get anything if you don't plant something. You don't plant something. You got to plant it. And start where you are. Don't get in condemnation about what you don't have. You know, God is not expecting you to give what you don't have. God know you ain't got but $5. So don't be concerned about it. Don't let other folks intimidate you because they're putting in more, and some people like to brag about what they put in church. Don't let people intimidate you. Walk in who you are. You know what you got. God know what you got. Okay? And God know when you're faking, when you're playing around. You know, God knows what you're doing. So God looks at your heart. Don't ever forget that. And by, you know, acknowledging, by giving these gifts to God, you are offering actually a part of you. You got to understand this. This money is a foldable you. You had to work to get that money. You had to put yourself out to get that money. And let's face it, money is precious to us. You know, we'll kill over some money, okay? We will fight you over some money. Well, in the church, we'll fight you over some money, okay? I'm sorry, but we will. So I'm just saying, so money is important. So when you're putting this money in, God understands how precious, because this is our method of exchange. You know what I'm saying? It's money. So when we put that money in there and you worked 40-hour week and overtime and everything else and been called everything but a child of God while you're on the job trying to do your best, you know, that's God said, that's a part of you. So God's not taking lightly what you do. So what I want to do is encourage you to understand how God is thinking, not about what I'm thinking about, what, you know, I'm looking over to see what you're putting in the basket, or, oh, child, she, you know, all this. I want you to understand what God, how God sees you, what you're doing. God knows your heart. And that's his heart. And he knows that you have, he's got to bring it out of us sometimes, but he knows that what he's put in you. Be followers, be imitators of God. And he's going to bring it out of you. If you have a desire, say, all you got to do is say, God, I want to do this. I can't do this. All I can do. God says, okay, I hear you. And God's going to start making a way. A little bit here, a little bit there. Here, a little there, a little. But it'll eventually come to you. And And understand this another thing, too, about God. When he gives to us, he's not giving out us because he needs to. He's giving to us because it's inherent in his nature. That's part of who God is. God is a giver. And when you get to really get to start, the more close you get to God, you begin to become a giver. And I'm going to just say this out. I'm going to put this out there. It's been a long time since I've seen folks give like our pastors do here. You know what I'm saying? How they bless us. You think about this. Y'all don't know some of the things they have done for us, and they have blessed us. And they have a given nature. You know what I'm saying? So it's there, and they do it, and you know, you learn from that. And when you're in that, when you're under leaders like that, then guess what? That stuff starts to get on you. That anointing starts to flow down on you. Next thing you want to try to give. And you can't, Bibles, what's that song we used to sing back there? You can't beat God's giving. Because the more you give to him, the more he gives to you. So I'm saying, when offering time comes, don't get tied up, get your pants all in a bunch, as they used to say. Just come on and just give what you have, and give it out of a heart of giving, a heart of giving. And understand that God is no gift, nothing that you do for God is going to go unnoticed by God. Now, I might not notice it, but God will. God will, and he will bless you. And he said, what you do in secret? He's, I'm going to show it openly. I'm going to show it. I'm gonna display it to you openly. So get your offerings together, get ready, and expect. Amen. Expect God to do what he said he gonna do. That's the other part of you. Just sit back there and just think, I'm just gonna pat my head. You got an enemy out there that don't want you to get nothing. Understand that you in a warfare. It's a spiritual warfare. You ain't fighting your sister so-and-so or brother so-and-so. You got an enemy that does not want you to succeed at anything. Finances, marriage, as parents, whatever, your job, he don't want you to exceed it. Nothing. Nothing that you're going to give God glory for. So just get your offerings together and know that God hears you. Now, we have a number if you're going to text. We have a 84321 as our text to give number. Or you can go on
at bridgechurchofal.com and follow the prompts, and I'll show you how to give. There are different ways to give. So we thank you and praise you for it. I'm going to pray over this. Father God, I thank you and I praise you for this finances, Father, this church. I thank you for all that every need in this ministry is being met, Father God. I thank you for these gifts, Father God. I thank you that you provide seed for the sower, Father God. I thank you that even now that as this ministry, as people are giving to this ministry, Father, even those that have, Father, for those that have a heart to give and maybe just don't have it, Father God, I thank you that you provide seed for the sowers, Father God. I thank you and I praise you that you supply every need, Father, of every person that's in this ministry, Father, for the good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, blessing, Father God. And I thank you there will be no lack in their lives, Father God. And I thank you and I praise you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Take it up. My God reigns. Our God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name. My God reigns. Our God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name. Woo! Glory to God. Amen. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. How's everybody this morning? A little cold in here? No? I feel a chill. It ain't the spirit. Is it in the spirit? I need to walk out and come back in? My God reigns. Yeah, I'm cold, Nicole. Yeah, me and Nicole, we got the same kind of blood going on. I'm cold, too. Good morning, everyone. Those of you that are here and those of you that are out there joining with us virtually, thank God so much for you guys for being with us. You know, that's my partner right there. She takes care of me. That's my sister, Kenithia. She comes in and take care of the pastor when the pastor cold. And when it get warm, because I'm going to start preaching now. I'm going to start preaching. Going to get warm in here. Especially those that I'm going to step on your toes. It's going to get warm in here. You might want to cut the AC on, but it's going to get warm. Amen. Welcome so much, guys. I welcome you again to here at the Bridge Church of Alabama, where we're loving God, loving people, pursuing purpose. We just thank the Lord that you have decided to join us today virtually as well as being with us today. How y'all doing today? Amen. Amen. I'm trying to focus this morning on the word, and then something came through the walls. Didn't sound like God. It sounded like an enemy trying to steal my joy. Said something about trying to come over and take over our football game day. I'm like, that devil is a lie. Man, I pulled up my sword and shield. Boy, about the boy. I'm like, I see you, Satan. I see you. I see you. I pulled out my sword and shield, man. Man, it was coming through the wall now. Coming through the wall, man. I'm telling you, y'all better get some holy water. So sprinkling down his chest. Look, I know we're doing that, you know, that COVID-19 stuff. When they walk through the door, we might want to take some other stuff. Do some other stuff walking through them doors. That spirit got to go. I'm like, what? Sidebar. I'm going to see you on the sideline. Hey, man. Man, you know, guys, man, you know we love having fun, man. I did consider having, you know, for a moment. What do they call that? A quick, like, kind of like, you know, it was like a moment. A fleeting moment. It was a fleeting moment, but it was gone before I can even get the whole thought out. You know, it was gone. Amen. So the brothers are going to enjoy themselves. Amen. By themselves, with themselves. And you guys want to go to a drive-thru, you can go to a drive-thru. I think, was that that Wing Stop or something like that? They might be showing the game there. They can always go there. Wing Stop, you know. What is it? I'm not right. Amen. Man, I thank you guys so much. Thank you for creating an atmosphere of joy in this place today, man. I tell you, the joy of the Lord, it makes a difference. Especially, you know, I heard my daughter, you know, Kenya, she was talking, you know, before that spirit came up on her, you know, about the football game. That spirit came up on her. She was, you know, she was serious, you know, earlier, you know. And so, you know, we thank God, you know, that you know how to reach him. You know how to contact him. You don't have to wait on nobody else. You know, you ain't got to call nobody's number. 911, they ain't answering. You know, you call on the Lord, you know, and God hears your cry. So I'm so glad that you know how to call upon him, and he's there with you. And we just thank God for your brothers and sisters that are here saying that, hey, we're going to hold you up and keep lifting you up. Whatever it is that you need from us, we got you. We got you. We like the military, man. We leave no man behind. No man, no woman behind. We got you. There ain't no reason why nobody should fall behind and get left. Mm-mm. We'll slow down if we have to. We ain't leaving nobody behind. Amen? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Heard the announcements, so you guys, please, you know, take care of the announcements. You know, there's some things going on. We are so grateful that we had an opportunity, man, to have 25 baskets for the people that are in need for this year. We do it every year. I'm just so grateful that our, you know, the families here, part of the Bridge Church of Alabama, you know, they don't find it robbery, you know, to sow into the lives of this community. They realize why they're here, and I thank God. And not only the people that are here, but I want to also give a shout out to those that sold sold seed virtually. You know, we have people that sold seed virtually and bought a basket or two. You know, we thank God for you two that are out there. I don't want to put out your names out there, but we thank God for you. Thank you so much for sowing into this ministry and into the lives of the people. You really don't. Some people, you know, sometimes when we get to a certain level in our lives, some of us may not even have ever been there before, where you don't know where your next meal coming from. You know, you just been blessed, you know, all your life. Some folks, and then some folks do remember where they came from. I remember my mother, man, and I'll never forget. It's like around the 20th of the month, she starts looking in the freezer and the refrigerator and starts trying to count the meals to last until the first of the month. And she would take some hamburger meat and she would make sure portions of this, and she would make sure there's just enough for us to get by until the first of the month. And so I remember, you know, and this is the thing, though. I remember that, but I don't remember ever going hungry. Because my mama, she just made sure, she made sure her children got fed. But as I got older, I realized the struggle it was to have to be concerned about her children. Now, she could have consumed all the meals upon herself and left us hungry. But I know there was probably many days that mama went hungry, but her children always ate. always ate. And I thank God for my mother. I thank God for just the grace that was on our lives back then, you know, and we didn't even know God like that, you know. But I believe that my mother knew God in her own special way before, you know, she totally gave her life to Christ. It was like you could still see the favor of God in our lives, even though she wasn't like serving him. It was just something about, this is the thing that I've come to understand about living for the Lord. And people say this often, but I think we say it too often or too fast where we really don't sincerely understand. Yes, God knows our heart. He does. He knows our heart. And people say that quickly. You know, God knows my heart. God knows my heart. But I think you need to understand God knows your heart, and he understands the purity of it, and he understands the struggles and the heart's desire of wanting to do right by him. See, yeah, some people say God knows my heart, but you really don't concern. You ain't concerned about God. You have no concern about living for him. You have no concern about wanting to do the right thing. You have no concern or desire to change your ways, you know. But when we say God knows my heart, and I say we, I'm talking about those people that honestly really want to change, you just want God to come in and do something for you. You know, yes, God knows your heart. And I believe it's those people that he'll do something, you know, just miraculously. He'll do it in their lives just because he knows that you have a heart desire to want to get right. And if you just make one decision, sometimes we're just one decision away from just getting it all together. That one decision is just trusting him completely. That one decision, just to trust him completely. And he knows that we're just one decision away. And I think he honors the fact that a heart wants to get right. I just do. That's just me. I just believe God honors that. It doesn't mean that he'll allow you to continue in sin. The Bible says, shall we continue in sin? God forbid. He doesn't want us to continue living that type of life. But I believe that it's those people who have a heart to want to do right, that every now and then God has just blessed them. Just to show them his grace and his mercy upon their lives. Just to show them how much he loves them. He said, through loving kindness have I drawn thee. Through loving kindness have I drawn thee. And I think every now and then he'll just express his love to those that are sinners. He expresses love. Amen. 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 Praise God. Well, let me pray, man. I done got into a sermon. Look, I could preach that all day right there. I could preach that connected right there. Man. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your loving kindness, which is better than life itself. We bless your holy name today. We thank you for the demonstration of what you have already done in this place. We pray now, Father, that you will continue to do the things that we need done in our lives, even if it means, God, that we may have to struggle a little bit. God, we just desire to want to be more like you, and it may be hard getting there, God, but we want you more than we want anything else, Father, because we know that you are the one that makes the difference in our lives. You make things better, God. So we ask today, God, that you send your word to us today. Allow us to hear from you. Speak, God, through these lips of clay. God, I am your servant, and all I've asked today is that your will be done. Your word be done, God. Your name be glorified today. Use me as your servant. And I pray for the hearers of your word today, Father, that you will bless them even the more. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Well, we are in the season of Thanksgiving, man. Anybody else think time is moving by really fast? It's like here we are again, man. Thanksgiving just that fast. I was looking back on the calendar and looking at some of the things that are coming up, and I was realizing that December the 6th, and I'll probably make mention of it again later on next month, but December the 6th would make 2 years this year that I've been cancer-free, praise the Lord. My last chemo, amen, amen. And, but sometimes I'm like, man, it's been 2 years already? I have to ask myself that, it's been 2 years already? It's like, man, God, okay. Sometimes, man, the Bible says we need to watch and pray. Watch and pray, because that means some things are happening, man, and you could miss God because things are moving so fast. And so here we are, we're in Thanksgiving season already again. I pray, man, that the people in this community, I don't know how we're going to deliver these baskets out to them, but But I pray, man, that when they get blessed today, or whatever day it is before Thanksgiving, whatever day we're gonna we're orchestrating how we're gonna give them out. But I pray that when they get blessed, man, that they will see God, that they will see God in it. You know, yeah, it comes from the Bridge Church of Alabama, but I want them to see God in it, man, because. You know, some of them, you know, the reason why they're in the position that they're in is because they just have not decided to trust God. And I just want them to see God. I want them to see just how much God loves them. So here we are, Thanksgiving all over again. Let's get into the Word. Let's get into the Word. I don't know. Okay, man, it's already okay. Well, see, I mean, time still going by fast. You keep talking, Pastor, it'd be time to go. Oh, man. Can someone ask me? I had a question this morning. Where's Brother? You know what? And when I was preparing for this word today, I was hoping that my brother would be here. Sister EJ, where my brother at? He's at home? Man, I needed him here today. I was going to call him up on stage today. Man, ain't that something, boy? I had a question, and I know he probably would have been one of the first ones to answer this question. Can someone answer me this one question? Now, I know how, I know how I've been taught in school how Thanksgiving originated. This is the question. Something to do with the name Christopher Columbus, who somehow convinced the native Indians of this land to sit down and have a dinner of thanks unto God while he stole their land. Did I say that out loud? But I wrote that. Man, was I supposed to say that out loud? Hold on. Native Indians of this land to sit down and have a dinner of thanks unto God. I think I was supposed to stop right there. No? Well, I just take the period out. While he stole their land. Yeah, I know. I know. We if you were like me, you were taught the glorious version of Christopher Columbus. You know, it was a glorious version, man. I mean, he almost became my hero. You know, just based on the story I was told, man. Man, what you want to be when you grow up? I want to be like Christopher Columbus. I want to sail the seven seas and be great and find land and bring it back. Yeah, that was the glorious version, the glorified version. Okay, back to my question. Okay, what's the question? Okay, here's the question. Anybody can answer it. Even you all can answer it out there. Put it in the chat. Why does a nation under God, indivisible, y'all remember that, right? I pledge allegiance to the flag. Why does a nation under God have to designate one day out of the year to stop and pause for a day to give thanks unto God? I'll read that question again. Why does a nation under God have to designate one day out of the year to stop and pause for a day to give thanks unto God? Anybody want to answer that? You ain't got to answer it. That's all right. You ain't got to answer it. I was reading in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44 in the New Living Translation. Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. And I think I'm going to answer my own question here. And if you wanted to answer that question, I think I'm going to give you an answer that may even be like yours or may be better than yours. Matthew chapter 5, verse 44, and I'm going to read 44 through 45 in the New Living Translation. This is Jesus talking. If you got that type of Bible where it's written in red, it says, "But I say, love your enemies, pray for those who persecute you. In that way you will be acting as true children of your Father in heaven. For he gives his sunlight to both the evil and the good. And he sends rain on the just and the unjust." Man, what a mighty God we serve. "For he gives his sunlight." Whose sunlight? His sunlight. Let's don't get it twisted. You know, I know we're doing a lot with the weather and everything like that, but it's God's sunlight. "His sunlight to both the evil and the good, and he sends rain on the just and the unjust alike." And so I read that scripture, and the thought that came to my mind was the world, well, I guess it's these United States. Anybody else celebrate Thanksgiving? It's the United States, right? It's a United States holiday. Yeah, I don't think no one else, because it was based on Christopher Columbus, the one who stole the, I mean, the one who sat down and gave thanks. And so this is your, I'm going to have to teach it right. You know, we got to teach it right. And so this is the United States of America. This is their holiday, but I believe that they're confused. Those that don't love God and have decided that they'd rather serve themselves than serve the God of all creation, they're failing to see that although God the Creator gives his sunlight to both the evil and the good and sends rain on the just and the unjust alike, they think they're blessed like we are, like true worshipers are. They think they're blessed like we're blessed. But I come today to tell them that they're not blessed like us. They're not blessed like us. They're not blessed like us. What they're experiencing is a loving, graceful God. When God says, I rain on them like he rains on us, all they're experiencing is just a graceful God. They're experiencing no more, no less, because the sunshine and that drizzle of rain is just given to them only because God is their creator, just like he's our creator. And so they're not getting anything special. They're getting it because he created them. And if they have to live in this world, then if it's going to rain, it's going to rain on them just as well as it's going to rain on us. And if the sunshine is going to come, and if he's going to supply sunshine, he's going to supply sunshine for them just like it is on us. See, but the sunshine that I get, let me tell you about the sunshine that I get, because, see, I'm one of God's favorites. See, I'm blessed. See, I'm not just the average Joe Blow, you know, who just want to give thanks once a year, you know, to a God who created everything. I'm not that guy. See, I'm the blessed guy who when God shines his sunlight on me, his sunlight is 1,000 times brighter than the average man's sunshine. I don't know, but I got any witnesses in there? Any witnesses in here? You, anybody else? Because the sunshine I get is more than sufficient. In fact, the rain that I get is more than just a drizzle. See, when he rains on me, he pours on me. He said in his word that he would open up the window of heaven and pour out a blessing. So when it rains on me, he rains on me tremendously. He rains on me better than he rains on the average sinner man. You see, we get what they're blindly missing out on, what the world is blindly missing out on. What we get, they're missing out on. It's called, if I had to name it, I call it benefits. What we get are benefits. What's a benefit? Dental insurance. Like dental insurance, but like what is it though? Say it again. Something that you basically have not earned or expect, right? It just comes as part of the package. It's like a package. It's something that is not what you would normally get. It's just a benefit, meaning that it's something extra. So a benefit is something extra. So when I talk about the world and them and how they want to thank God once a year, and us believers, we get benefits. They miss out on the benefits. They don't see what we get. But because they have misinterpreted the scripture where God says, I rain on the just as well as the unjust, and I shine on the just as well as the unjust, they got it twisted. They think they getting the same benefit we getting. No, you ain't getting the benefit, world. You're not getting the benefit. All you're doing is just getting the average. You're just getting the standard package. It's a standard package. But we getting the package that's a glorified package. It comes with benefits. It comes with benefits. Let me tell you what Psalm, go to Psalm 68:19 in the New King James Version. Psalms chapter 68:19. What does it say? Psalm 68:19. Psalm 68:19 in the NKJV version. It says this. It says, blessed be the Lord who what daily loads us with what? Benefits. The God of our salvation. Selah. He does it how often? He blesses me daily. daily. The sinner man can't say that. If they're saying that, that means that they understand that God is blessing them, but they don't deserve it. They understand that that's God's grace working in their lives. But God blesses me daily. He blesses me daily with what? Benefits. My God, I'm about to shout just right there just to think about it. Let's go to Psalms chapter 103. Nicole, God still ain't done yet. Psalms chapter 103, verse 2, in same version. It says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his what? Benefits. Who he talking to? He talking to us. He's talking about his children. He's talking to, he ain't just talking to the created. He's talking to the ones that have been created and blessed and called by his name. That's who he's talking to. Benefits. He said, oh, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Sometimes you just got to take the time out and pause, not just once a year, but every day and count the benefits. You got to count the benefits. Sometimes you got to stop and say, God, did I deserve that? Did I deserve to wake up this morning? Man, that's a benefit. Man, I woke up this morning and the heat was still working. The lights were still on. That's a benefit. My God, man, look, God still ain't done. Nicole, go to Psalms chapter 116 and 12. Psalms chapter 116 and 12. Woo, man. Now when you think about it, you got to ask yourself this question. What shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits toward me? What do I give a God like that? How do I repay him? See, that's somebody. See, David had an opportunity to sit back and think about the benefits that he gets from the Lord. And he's like, man, my benefits are so good. I got to do something to pay you back, God. What do I render to a God who has blessed me like this every day? He blesses me with benefits. Oh, these benefits are so good. How do I get back to him? Some folks can't even give God a $5 bill doing offering. And they live in it. Now, I'm not talking about the sinner man. I'm talking about God's children that call themselves saved, that are blessed by the Lord, that are receiving these benefits daily. And you can't even get $5 out of them. I told somebody, look, I don't know. I told you, man, you might want to cut the AC on. It's getting hot up in here now, ain't it? Cut the AC down a little bit, sir. You cut it down a little bit. It's getting hot up in here. Woo! Woo, it's hot. Woo! Gah! But they don't want to, they want to bless God. God, sometimes God says, this is what I want you to do. You pray, you say, God, order my steps. And then God comes back, he order your steps, tell you to do something. You say, God, I ain't doing that. I ain't doing that. I ain't going to apologize to him. I hear you, God, but I ain't apologizing to her. She knew she was wrong. As though God didn't know. God knows she was wrong too. But God's trying to take you to another level so that you can get an increase in benefits. Because each time you do something for the Lord, he increases his benefits. That's why they come daily. See, I watched God work in my life where I was getting benefits every now and then. But the closer I got to him, the closer I get to you. The more I got closer to God, man, his benefits got better and better and betterer. They did, Canivia. They got betterer, man. And his benefits, and now I'm appreciating, I'm seeing God's benefits on my life every day, y'all. It was once upon a time, you know, I would get this. How they would say, every blue moon, I would see a benefit, and I knew I didn't deserve it. But now, man, I'm seeing benefits every day, man. Benefits every day. David said, what do I give back to you, Lord? What do I give back to you? Is there anybody in here know of his benefits? Anybody in here know of his benefits? How about one? Let me just call out one benefit. How about his favor? The favor of the Lord upon your life. His favor. Anybody here ever experienced God's favor before? Anybody out there experienced God's favor before? God's favor upon your life. I'm talking about opportunities that he orchestrates in our life that demonstrates how magnificent he is. That's his favor. He orchestrates things in our lives, man. We don't even know how he does it. And but we just realize all of a sudden we like, man, when did that happen? Like, God, that had to be you. That had to be you. God, I thank you. I wasn't even expecting this, Lord. Thank you. He orchestrated. That's favor. Favor, oh man, that's the type of God I serve. Favor. Man, what about the God who supplies all my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus? Some of them, they never read that scripture before. Go to Philippians chapter 4:19, Nicole, in the NKJV version. Philippians chapter 4:19. Paul said this. Paul said, and my God, see, he made it personal. He said, my God. See, my God, the one who benefits me, who gives me my benefits, and my God shall supply how many? All your need according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. All, that's favor. Every need is met. When I think about all the amazing things he supplies me with, they're sufficient for every day. Everything God supplies me with is enough, man. It suffices. It takes care of me every day. Who was it who said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread? Was that David? He said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. Why not? Because the favor that's upon their life. Because he bestowed them with benefits every day. Benefits. Can I name some more? Yes. I'll name favor. Let me name some more. How about forgiveness? Yes. That's a benefit. God don't have to forgive me. He don't have to forgive you. What about forgiveness? He don't have to forgive us, but he does. He does. He forgives us. How about acceptance? When we don't deserve to be accepted. The Bible says this, said that our righteousness is no more than filthy rags. So when he sees our righteousness, he can just push us away. But instead, he sees the blood of Jesus upon our righteousness. And we can plead the blood of Jesus over our lives, and then he accepts us into his home. He accepts us into his heart. Acceptance. How about this? How about grace? We're talking about grace. What is grace? Grace is receiving those things that you don't deserve, but he gives them to you anyway. That's another benefit. Yeah, he gives us grace, and we don't even deserve it, but he gives it to us anyway. Grace. The Bible says that his grace is sufficient. What about the joy? Joy. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it to me. This world that I have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. The world can't take it away. Why? Because my joy, the joy that he's given me, is not based on circumstances. Come on, man. Come on. The joy that he's given me is not based on whether or not I feel good or feel bad. No, the joy that God's given me, man, it's supernatural joy. Where's that at? Where, go to Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. And let's go in the New King James Version. Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. Then he said to them, go your way, eat the fat, drink the sweet, and send portions to those for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy to our Lord. Do not sorrow, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Yeah. Jesus, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Woo, man. Fred Hammond, in one of his verses, in one of his songs and verse, he said, I'll exchange my weakness for your joy. God, I exchange. Let's make an exchange. I want to make an exchange. I want to exchange my weakness for your joy, because the joy of the Lord is my strength. So I'm exchanging my weakness for God's joy. Woo, God, and I begin to feel stronger now. I begin to feel better now, man, because I'm exchanging my weakness for his joy, because the joy of the Lord is my strength. Oh, my God. What about the blessings of the Lord? The Bible says that the blessings of the Lord maketh rich and addeth no sorrow. Blessings on blessings. Man, I thought you were going to do that song today. Turn around. Blessings. Blessings. Blessings on blessings. Come on, man. Every time I turn around. Oh, man. Oh, there goes another one. Oh, Lord. There's another blessing. What? Man, blessings upon blessings upon blessings. And they want to wait one day a year and thank the Lord? One day? You going to give God one day? Out of 365 days of blessings, you going to just take one day out and bless God? Man, I wake up every morning and say, God, when I sit up on my bed, I say, Lord, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And every morning, sometimes my back hurting, my neck hurting, but I'll sit up on my bed, and sometimes I got to get up slow. Oh. But when I get to that place, man, I sit up. I was like, Lord, thank you. Oh, God. Hey, God. Yes, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. I heard another songwriter say that it could have went another way. Could have went another way. So I get up on my bed, man. I thank the Lord. The first thing come out of my mouth, Lord, thank you. I come home from work and I walk in my house. Thank you, Father. I made it home. Come on now. Woo! And not only did I make it home, but when I got there, there was a home. It was a home. How many people get home and their wives done packed up everything? They gone, walk into an empty house. Husband gone, walk into an empty house. Note on the counter. Sorry, it's over. We was working this thing out, but I can't take it no more. I'm out. Man, when you think about the benefits of the Lord, come on, man. Benefits of the Lord. And last but absolutely not least, y'all ready for this one? Y'all ready for this benefit? Woo! This is a good benefit right here. Cliff, you ready? Woo! The power over the enemy. The power over the enemy. The power over the enemy. I can stomp on his head. I can knock his teeth out. The power over the enemy. You see, the world don't have that. They ain't got that. They don't have the power. They don't have the power to rebuke Satan. Only God's saints got the power to rebuke Satan. He said, "Get thee hence behind me." The Bible says, "If you resist him, he'll flee from you." That's why I miss you. See, girl, I'm about to throw this pen at you, man. Woo. He said, "If you resist him, he'll flee from you." The world can't resist him. Why? Because he lives in them. He lives in them. But he don't live in us. So every time he tries to come back in and try to make entry again, we resist him. And he flees from us. Man, that's power over the enemy. I love that benefit. I love that benefit. Why? Because Jesus said this. He said, "The thief cometh but to steal, kill, and to destroy." Now, I mean, I'm tired. I'm sick and tired. Any more kind of tired? Tired, tired. Tired, tired of being sick and tired. Of the enemy stealing, killing, and destroying everything that I try to earn. I'm sick and tired. But now that I got God on my side, say, greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world. Hey, the Bible says, let him that stole steal no more, Sister Mary. Let him that stole steal no more. Put them in check. Say, oh, what was that? Wait a minute. No, bro. No, this is my house, and I live here. You ain't welcome here no more. No more. You ain't welcome here no more. These are benefits the average man or woman don't get to enjoy. They don't get to enjoy those benefits. This is what I was thinking, and I'm going to close with this last scripture. So we see the benefits of the Lord. We see them come. The Bible says we get them daily. The Bible tells us this. Go to Revelation chapter 12, verse 10 and 11 in the NIV version. Revelation chapter 12, verse 10 and 11. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our brothers and sisters," who's Satan? He's the accuser, because what he does, he goes before God and says, "Look what they did. Look what they did. Look. He's a tattletale. Every time we mess up, every time we make a bad decision, and that's contrary to God's will, And sometimes we do it on purpose. We know we're doing it wrong. He's right there in God's face. Look what Terrence done did. Look. He's the accuser of the brethren. He's the accuser of the sisters. He wants God to take back or take off of us the salvation that he's given us. The salvation that has been paid for. He wants God to revoke it. So he goes back and forth trying to accuse us, always telling God what we done did. Like God don't know already. But he's the accuser of the brothers and sisters who accuses them before our God day and night has been hurled down. They triumph over him by the blood of the Lamb. Come on, who's the blood of the Lamb? Jesus' blood, right? He's the Lamb. By Jesus' blood, who is the Lamb, and by the word of what? Their testimony, our testimony. They did not love their lives so much as to shrink from death. He says that we overcame Satan by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. The word of our testimony. I was going to have testimony service today. But one of the things that the Holy Ghost said, he said, why are you always testifying? And ain't nothing wrong with this, but why are you always testifying what God has done? He said, won't we start testifying what you believe God to do? Testify what you believe God's going to do. I mean, that's even a greater testimony because that talks about how much you believe God. So I'm going to testify what God has not even done yet, but I'm going to believe it because I'm going to believe those things to be not as though they are. Because I'm going to believe God. So I'm testifying. Lord, I thank you right now. Even though that the paperwork says that I'm 90% disabled, I'm waiting on VA. God, I thank you, God, that I'm 100% disabled, total disabled. I'm waiting on God to do that. But the testimony would come after it happens, right? God is like, no, don't wait until after it happened. He said, speak it now. He said, why don't you start giving testimonies before I do the work? Man, you think you got benefits now? If we start blessing the Lord for the things he has not done yet, just start blessing him. Just thank God. Thank you for it. Thank you, God, that my back is completely healed. Ooh, thank you, God, I can run like a teenager again. Climb, I can climb. Well, he won't be climbing nothing. I don't need to climb nothing. Some things I need to, you know, continue, you know, I just need to just do what, you know, people of my age do. But is that, if I climb, it might mess up my benefit. Don't want to be a, look, the Bible says that he said disobedience is like witchcraft. He said, look, I don't want to be disobedient now, Lord. You ain't told me to climb nothing. So I'm going to just, you know, but it's nice to know that if I had to, that he's endowed me to be able to do it, right? Because I get the daily benefits. He has blessed me daily with benefits, daily with benefits. See, sometimes we have to take the time out and not just once a year, but every day give thanks, for that is the will of God. That's the Bible. The Bible says, in all things give thanks, which is the will of God. That's his will in all things. He said, find something good out of it. It may not be what you want. It may not happen the way you thought it was supposed to happen. Find something good out of it. Even if you live to tell a story, that's a benefit. God says, look, in all things give thanks, which is the will of God. It's God's will. And so I'm going to thank God every day, every day. And so let the world continue to do it once a year if they want to. They're not going to be a partaker of these benefits. And when they look at my life, when they look at your life, they're going to see a difference. Oh, yeah, it rains on the just as well as the unjust. Go on and get your little, what's that called, a little shower, a little drizzle. Go on, enjoy yourself. Yeah, go on there, play in the puddle. Go on. But when God rain on me, man, whew, when God rain on his children, it's nothing to compare. Nothing to compare. Amen. Amen. God bless y'all, man. Thank y'all so much. I guess that was my Thanksgiving message. Amen. Amen. Look here, you need to be thanking God all the way up until Turkey Day. Keep on thanking him. And even after Turkey Day, thank him. Thank him. Watch what happens when you begin to bless the Lord for the things he hasn't even done yet. That's Thanksgiving right there, man. Bless his name for the things he hasn't done yet. And then this is the hard part. Y'all ready for this one? If he takes away all the things he blessed you with, will you continue to bless him? Will you continue to thank him? If he takes away, if God himself says, okay, I'm going to take this away from you, and it's going to hurt. It's going to hurt, but I'm going to take it away from you. Will you still bless him? Man. Man. That's the true believer. That's the true worshiper. Somebody's going to bless the Lord even if God says, you know what, your blessing season is over. But I just thank God that he's not like that, though. He's a blessing kind of God. And, you know, we say that just in case it does happen. But the type of God I serve, he's going to always bless us. He's going to always bless us. Hey, family, friends, thank you guys so much for joining us today. Thank you guys again for coming out with us. Look here, man, we love you so much. We want to give you, if you're out there and you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, or you don't even know God as your creator, you just heard about him, you realize, you know, that there may have been something like that, but, you know, someone has been trying to tell you about the Big Bang story or something like that. Look here, I decree and declare right now that every lie you've been told, right now, dissolve and disintegrate out of your life right now, and it no longer exists, and that the truth of God will begin to rise up in your life right now in the name of Jesus. Look here, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior and you desire to do that, I have a simple prayer. I say it every Sunday. It's just a simple prayer of salvation. And this prayer is even for those that may have given their life to Christ but backslid, but wants to come back home to the Father. You can do this. You can say the same prayer. It's just a prayer acknowledging that God is your creator, acknowledging that Jesus died on the cross for your sins. And through his death and through his resurrection, you now can have eternal life, new life in Jesus Christ. Isn't that marvelous, man? That's fantastic, where you can have new life begin all over. He can start changing those things that were bad. He can start renewing some of those things in your life. All it takes is this is one decision, and that is a decision to make this prayer from your heart with me. If you're ready, come on, say this prayer with me. Father God, you know my life, and you know how I've lived it. I ask you, Father, to come into my heart and forgive me for my sins. I believe in your Son. His name is Jesus. He died on the cross for me. They buried him. But on the third day, he rose with all power in his hands. That power is what saves me. Thank you, Father, for saving me and giving me new life through Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen, man. We applaud you. I don't know who you are. You said that prayer from your heart. God has restored you into the fold. He's going to show you some things. If you think he's already done some things in your life, you have not seen nothing yet. The Bible says that eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor has it entered into the hearts of men, the things that God has prepared for them that walk uprightly before him. You haven't seen it yet. God's about to do some new things in your life. All you got to do is just continue to keep that communication open. Keep it open. Keep praying. Keep thanking him. Keep talking to him. You don't have to have all these big words that you hear these preachers preach. Man, just talk to him like you talk to your brother or your sister. Just talk to him. Say, God, I'm hurting today. Do you care? Talk to him and watch God begin to move in your life. Hey, guys, man, I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for joining us and all of you Bridgeites that are here today. We praise God for you. I think you're not a first-time guest. You're part of the family now. I don't want to call you first-time guest. But thank you so much for coming out again. We appreciate you so much. Your presence does mean something to us. We realized that we were gone, but a couple weeks ago, and didn't get a chance to see you, but I'm glad that we had the opportunity to see you again this Sunday. For those of you that are out here, you guys know what time we're here. Please continue to join in with us. I did want to announce that this Wednesday, we're canceling Bible study. We're not canceling it. We're postponing it. We're not going to do Bible study because some of us got to labor in the kitchen for the turkey day. And I've been given some tasks, and the list is continuing to get longer. And so I'm going to go ahead and just do the needful thing at the house so I can be really happy on Thanksgiving Day. And so I'm not going to be able to do Bible study on Wednesday night. What I will do, though, we started, what was that on last Wednesday? We had a pre-recorded of Generational Curse last Wednesday. It was part one. We're gonna show part two this coming Wednesday. So for those of you that just, you know, are cooking and you want to hear, you know, some good teaching while you're cooking, we're gonna do part two of Generational Curses this coming Wednesday night. So you'll still get Bible study, but it won't be a live Bible study. Is that all right? Good. Amen. That's all right. And the women of purpose, yeah, we need to make sure that you all are meeting after church. Please don't leave too swiftly. First Lady wants to meet with everyone. I understand there's supposed to be some names exchanged and stuff like that. And so we're going to see who get the biggest gift. Amen. Amen. Love you guys so much. Look here, I'm Pastor T here at the Bridge Church of Alabama, where we're loving God, loving people, and pursuing purpose. We do this because this is the only way. We know that this way pleases God. We love you guys so much. And on behalf of the Bridgeites here, the First Lady, Latrilla, we love you guys. And until the next time, which will probably be next Sunday, we'll see you guys. And you know what's coming next? I'm out. Love you, man. May God be with you. Continue to bless you in Jesus' name. Enjoy your Thanksgiving. Amen. God bless.